What's going on, YouTube? Happy New Year! What's going on, everybody? I know y'all see my Christmas tree in the background. Yeah, that's right. Nah, it's been a long time, everybody. I apologize to some of y'all because I've not done a review or anything as far as me talking about any kind of like Marvel or DC related things or any kind of TV shows or any kind of movie reviews in a long time. Y'all seen probably some of my like projects and stuff that I had going on, like the Dance Time projects. Any of y'all that follow my other YouTube channels, such as Super SEL 0220 or Earl Leg 423, y'all seen I posted a lot of different things. To be quite honest, like I've been super, super busy. I had to at least come up here today and say to y'all, like, Happy New Year. I've, like, seriously valued a lot of y'all's comments and likes and posts. Like, yeah, y'all are awesome. But on the real, I really had debated if I was going to even continue doing, like, movie reviews or even having myself being shown on YouTube altogether. And I know that sounds crazy because I know y'all seen me do the dance thing. You know y'all seen me kind of do some of the other projects, like the short films I've got kind of going on. And I'll go into those in a little bit, but I came to the conclusion, especially like today, like really like self-analyzing everything, that even though like I'm busy and all this kind of stuff is going on, like I find a lot of joy in just posting things up, even if it's me. Literally going into my own personal perspective of the movie world or the entertainment world, or even like stuff talking about like politics or spiritual stuff. Like I love doing that and I guess I'm not going to stop, but I had to come to that revelation for myself, just like everybody else kind of has to this on YouTube. You know, at a certain point you're like, man, how long can I continue doing this? But you know what? I'm not going anywhere. So that's some good news. And it sucks because all like I've seen so many movies, y'all. I've seen Catching Fire, I've seen The Hobbit, I've seen so many different movies in the theater that I have not reviewed, and even movies now that are out on like Blu-ray and DVD, like I just have not done reviews on them. What was one that I wanted to do? And I told y'all, I believe it was, I can't remember the name of it. But it's Battling Robots. I can't remember the name of it. Anyway, I do know that I promise I will be doing some more reviews, not just on movies, but also on TV shows. Just to give y'all kind of like a taste and tidbit, these are some shows I actually really do like as well. And I know y'all kind of heard me talk around them, but I'm going to show you how serious I am about them. Anybody seen this show? Or maybe this show? Those shows, I love. I've followed from episode one all the way to now. And, I mean, even with The Vampire Diaries, also the originals. Like, I think that that's probably going to be the first one because, like, The Vampire Diaries, now they're on, like, their fifth season. It's going to be hard for me to kind of go all the way back. If y'all want me to, I can go into reviews of, like, now starting on. But I don't think I'm going to go all the way back. I just don't have the time for it. But I mean, if y'all want, like, I'll definitely talk about Vampire Diaries. Arrow is just on the second season, so I can go back. Because I'm actually going back through the Blu-ray box set that I bought for Black Friday. Which, by the way, Black Friday was nuts, y'all. I am happy that Best Buy, they actually did, like, the cool thing of actually going in. And they opened up the stores on Thanksgiving, which kind of sucks. But at the same time, it was cool because I could get my stuff and then leave. They opened up doors at 6 o'clock, so I was in there to get in there, get me a TV, get in there, and get, I think, my mom a Microsoft Surface, and then give me some movies, and so it worked out really well. They had to stay there all night, but that's a whole different story. I wanted to talk to y'all about that. In later news, I will talk about three different, like, deaths. Three. First, I would say is definitely, and I'll go into this because I wanted to do, like, my thought process on this. The late, great Paul Walker. I've been following the dude for a minute. Since the first Fast and Furious, from movies like Running Scared. The dude, he was just an awesome actor. And he seems, though, he was a good person. He was a good humanitarian, from what I'm understanding. He will be sorely missed. Mandela, Idris Elba, Morgan Freeman, they've portrayed the roles on screen. Jennifer, I think Jennifer Hudson, she also did kind of like a rendition on his wife in one movie. I mean, so many great things that they've shown on the screen, but just what he did, like, I mean, he passed away. And then today, I'm not sure if y'all know about it, but Uncle Phil from The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, he died today on the first of the new year, which is very sad as well. But I had to talk about them as well. Yeah, their family's gonna be in my prayers. I'm gonna continue to be praying for them. I hope y'all do the same. But yeah, dude, it's a lot been going on, and I haven't been able to talk to y'all about it. I think the last thing that I actually did face to face and talking about it was like my Grand Theft Auto review, and I didn't even finish that because Grand Theft Auto just kind of like crashed as far as the online, but it's good now. And they've got a lot of new DLC coming out. They've got a lot of new like things like the heist and the own character creation for the like maps and the death matches, and it's just gonna be nuts. I may go into more of that, but y'all, I'm gonna be getting some help, and it's gonna be like a new template and everything for how like the scope of my channel is gonna look, especially this channel. I can't speak for the other ones because I've got a lot of other things going on with those. It kind of is hard when you do everything, like when you do like the video editing, you do like the picking of the music, and you do the reviews, and then you go do the research. So I'm gonna be probably putting together like a team. Reason why I say that is because with the different films that I've been working on, which is Big Movie for the Dance Time. Any of y'all look at my Dance Time videos, like that Big Movie is what I've been working on nonstop. And I've been doing the final touches on it. It kind of sucks because I'll show y'all this because I never show y'all. This is my laptop. Hold on. I don't want to drop it. Yeah, you know you like that background. But my laptop has been having issues. Any of y'all tech nerds out there, I've got 4 gigs worth of DDR3 RAM up in it right now. It was at 8. I believe my board might be bad because my other 4 gig stick is actually, it looks like it's burnt. Try to replace it out, didn't work. So I'm working at like half the speed of what my laptop's supposed to be. So whenever you're doing like video editing, like Final Cut, and you're trying to do stuff like iMovie or anything like that, it takes a lot. And so for what I really want to do for our channel, I can't. So I'm kind of limited. Not just that, like I work on a regular basis as well. I work, also volunteer with the outreach group in Washington, D.C. And I actually go back and forth from North Carolina as well and doing different things. And so I am a busy man. But there is great things ahead. Like between the Dance Time feature, also got a documentary coming out. I'm not gonna spoil you on that. The outreach group that I'm working with, Humble Beginnings Outreach Group, already done like 2 short films. One it's actually really cool. Another one, I'm still working on the steps behind it. Only thing I can say is a person just gets out of prison, and they live a life of crime, and now they're out of prison, and like they're trying to place themselves back in a world that's changed completely. But they were changed eternally in the prison, and it's got a really good message behind it. I did the storyboarding behind it. I got the actors and I'm getting somebody working on the music. Look for One Shot. One Shot, this dude. If you go check out One Shot 09 on SoundCloud, the dude will not disappoint you, I promise you. Anyway, he's gonna be working with a lot of the score for not just that, but the other projects that I'm working on. Got another guy that's an animator, and y'all have seen his videos, and he's actually dance. He's a great dancer as well. Joe Johnson or JoJo, Mojo, whoever you want to call him. The dude has animation skills, and in addition to that, he's also a lyricist and a dancer. So I'm working with him, but it's so many other different people, and I just like only naming some names. Like another guy up here, Sean Turntine. The dude is an amazing graphic artist, photographer, philanthropist, everything you can kind of think of. And I mean, he's even got like a sermon online as well. So I'm working with a lot of awesome people on a lot of different projects. I kind of wanted to keep y'all in the loop because it's been such a minute before I put anything up here. And I'm not sure if this is relevant to any of y'all. But the other thing that I have been waiting to talk about is Man of Steel 2. And the reason why I say that is because there's been so much stuff going on. I mean, I think what I'll do is I'll post a link. I did a graphic design of two people that I wanted to kind of take place in the movie. One, and y'all might fault me for this, I would love, hear me. I know a lot of people want Mark Strong, Bryan Cranston. But personally, for Lex Luthor and Man of Steel 2, I would love to see Matt Damon. I'm gonna just leave the record at that. We've heard like now that it's official that Gal Gadot from the Fast and Furious series, she's gonna be playing Wonder Woman. She did a review and an interview. I think it was a French interview, but she was talking about how her excitement of the role and like she knows that she's very skinny and she's gonna get herself prepared mentally, emotionally, and of course physically. And when she gets toned, of course that's gonna gain body mass. So it's gonna be interesting. I think she's gonna do well. I worry, and AMC Theaters, like they did a good interview about what they thought the five things they need for like the Man Still to be successful. And I mean, I think it was really good points. And if they stick to the source material and trying to make sure they develop Man of Steel, Clark Kent, as a character after the events, and they make sure they personalize that, in addition to adding like a story arc for Batman and just keep it centralized like that, they'll be fine. They shouldn't try to recreate what Avengers did because Avengers, they had multiple different movies ahead of it. And I know everybody's waiting for the Justice League, but like you got to get your foundation straight first before you just add all a whole bunch of different characters in. I mean, another one I'm really hyped for, if y'all haven't seen it, is The Amazing Spider-Man 2. I mean, they've got the Sinister Six involved in it. I mean, I don't know if y'all saw the trailer. There was a New Year's post for it as well, and it was pretty epic seeing Jamie Foxx's Electro, so many different actors in that, and I mean, that's a whole different topic. The only reason why I'm up here now is I'm kind of giving y'all a tease of some of the stuff that I'm gonna be talking about in the future, like letting y'all know that I'm still here, like I'm still like a geek, a tech geek. I still love God. I still care about y'all. I still am working on brand new things, and I mean, I look forward to hearing what y'all have to say about everything. And I mean, I know this is kind of weird now, with me on my phone. This is not gonna be a regular thing. I left my charger for my laptop at work. So my laptop is out of commission, and I mean, I couldn't really use it halfway decent before anyway. But today I'm gonna finish up looking at or rewatching The Vampire Diaries, and I think I'm probably gonna look at American Horror Story. I've been looking at a little bit of second season. I finished the first season finally on Netflix. There's so much, y'all. Like, it's so much to talk about. But anything that I talked about, any topic at all, even if you thought about me, if y'all are happy that I'm still gonna be doing this, if y'all are not, I mean, I still look forward to hearing y'all's thoughts, y'all's opinions. People that I've been following actually on YouTube that's been doing really well. The Gamer 2323, if y'all are looking for a good insight person that's really funny and it's really enthusiastic about informative gaming news, the guy is good. And he's got a Twitch account. I've actually got a Twitch account of myself. I've been helping out with a lot of different people on Twitch, one of whom is the Respawn Podcast. Respawn Podcast, they are really good people. Jay and Kyle, they do their thing. And they not only like stream all the time different games such as Smite for PC, such as Battlefield for Xbox One. They host events as well. And I had to give them a shout out as well because I did two promotional videos for them. But yeah, I've been all over Twitch as well. Typical Gamer, I've been following him as well on YouTube. He's been doing really well as far as like the GTA stuff. So that kind of like, man, I don't want to put anything else about GTA because he's like killing it right now. And then of course CK 9138. I mean, he's the man. I mean, he's now on Instagram, which I am too. He's definitely been on Twitter. Dude's just good people. I mean, he's the biggest Superman fan I've ever known. And I mean, I call myself one of the biggest Batman fans, but you can't see in my apartment like a whole bunch of like familiar for Batman. You can see a lot of movies about Batman, but not action figures and all that kind of stuff. I have a Grig comic book collection, but not to the depth that CK has. And mad respect for him. Mad respect for him. But yeah, I just wanted to talk to y'all what I've been looking at, who I've been looking at, what I've been up to. But I'm not going anywhere. And I've got more things in store. If y'all have like a recommendation of a movie that y'all think I should watch and review, please like leave the comment at the bottom. I'm also huge into music. I'm not sure if any of y'all know Kurt Hugo Schneider. Him and either his brother, I'm not sure if they're brothers or not, but Max. I've been following their channel, and like they just are great. Pentaphonics, they've been really great. And all the covers they've been doing. So, I mean, it's just a lot. I mean, anything y'all want me to talk about, if it's music related, if it's movie related, if it's entertainment related, if it's spiritually, like on my other channel, Super SEL, I do more about like different sermons and different thought perspectives on different things. I've even gone to different concerts, a group. I went to different concerts even last night. And I'm be probably filming a lot and probably doing like kind of like music videos for them, just to show support. And also, I'm probably going to be doing a lot more music reviews, but like I'm only one man, so I'm going to need help. So any of y'all, if y'all want to help or if y'all want to be supporters or anything like that, like just hit me up and leave your comments at the bottom. Y'all have a great and happy, happy new year. Welcome to the first. RIP to all those three that I've named out today, especially Uncle Phil today. God bless you and your family. Like you've been a blessing. And y'all personally have been a blessing to me. So I'm not going anywhere. Later. Peace. Happy New Year. SELs are through Israel. Signing out.